Welcome to the Mount Van Hovenberg cross-country course for the final day of biathlon action at these Lake Placid 2023 Games. It's looking absolutely gorgeous. We've had lots and lots of snow over the last day and a half, but the afternoon has cleared. There's even a glimmer of sunlight, and the Adirondacks are looking fabulous. So is the track. There's been plenty of action on here over the last 10 days. And there's been some action already today with the men's mass start. That was won by a Frenchman. Who is going to take the advantage here in the women's 12.5 kilometer mass start? Got a field of 30 athletes chosen from the best results of the all the events here over the last 10 days. And this is the fourth women's event of biathlon of the games, if you don't count the mixed start, the mixed relay as well. So that was a shot of Skripkina of Kazakhstan. And the athletes just preparing now. They're just a few minutes away from getting this race underway. Now the ski technicians, the real alchemists of the sport, they've been doing their work, making a huge difference to performances. So we'll have 5 2.5 kilometer laps, bringing us to a total of 12.5 kilometers and 4 shooting bouts for this women's mass start. So the 30 highest ranked athletes at these games, representing 13 countries, just completing their preparations ahead of the start. And today's race really all about those athletes going head to head against each other, all starting at the same time. The leading three here are multi-medalists at these games already, and you have to fancy their chances for more medals in this mass start as well. Field of 30. Zoe Picos of Canada in there, Chloe DuPont representing Great Britain. So we go over to the starting line. I'm looking out across the stadium, and the ones nearer the back just beginning to settle down. So temperature dropping a little, -5 degrees. And they're away in this women's 12.5 kilometer mass start. Leading athletes from Canada, Poland, and the Czech Republic, and Kazakhstan, and Ukraine. Also in there is Anna Blanc of France, a compatriot winning the men's race earlier this afternoon here in Lake Placid. So Anna Nedza-Kubiniec of Poland is an early leader. You can see Russo chasing. We've got 2 splits on the course itself at 1.4 kilometers, and then one at 2.1. And then, of course, they come back down into the stadium for the shooting stage. Thank you. Our field of 30 are all away, being led by Nedza Kubinets of Poland. Polina Yegorova of Kazakhstan in second. The Canadian, Charlotte Russo in third. But very, very early days. And if you're new to biathlon, you'll soon see that the lead changes, positions change all the time, especially as they come into the shooting range. Almost 3 minutes into the race, and the competitors getting into their rhythm. Just trying to work out who's looking strong, who's looking less strong, working out their tactics and strategy as the Finns move through that camera shot. Their dark blue suits. Number of climbs on this course, hard work of course, but the descents can also be tricky. Steep and fast, especially that final long one down into the stadium. But Nedza Kubinets of Poland looking good at the front of the field. Yegorova of Kazakhstan in second, and Russo. A hugely successful Canadian athlete at these games is sitting in third. Yulia Horodna of Ukraine in fourth. Bronze medalist in the mixed relay. Looking to obviously improve on that. Grab a medal of silver or gold colour this time round. So we're at that first split at 1.4k. And just looking down the field, looking at around 23 seconds separating first from last. Another climb towards our second checkpoint. No change to the order. Everyone just biding their time at this point. Finland with the number 14 on her leg there, just making it to the brow of the hill. Now start the process of catching their breath, slowing the heart rate down. Any misses mean a 150 meter penalty loop. Misses flash up as red, so a miss for Joranen. Nedza Kubinets misses a shot. So it's a penalty loop for Nedza Kubinets. Russo has a clean round. Two misses for Yegorova of Kazakhstan. And so Russo takes an early advantage. Following her out of the stadium is Stebelina of Ukraine. Number 12 is Bartova of the Czech Republic. Also there is Fischer of Switzerland. So looking at that split, between the leader and 10th place, you're looking at around 45 seconds. So all this could yet change if Russo is off target. Kilometer split. Russo's increased her lead by another second. It's up to 18.3. Nedza Kubin of Poland has moved up into third. Nowotna, who was third, has dropped to fifth. Bartova of the Czech Republic in fourth. It's a miss already on the first shot. Second shot's good. A second miss for Russo. Oh, two penalty loops for the Canadian, and that is going to turn things around. Nedza Kubinets closest to us now. Two French athletes, Blanc and Machu, are in and about to start their shooting. Penalty for Fischer. So the Canadian, Shiloh Russo, is carrying out her penalty laps already. And it's going to be Stabilna of Ukraine who exits in the lead. There she is. Bartova of the Czech Republic moves up into second place. And then we've got Nowotna, her teammate, with the number 11 bib there in third. Machu of France, good round for her. And our leading three athletes getting 20 out of 20 in the range. And Machu has made up a lot of time now on the leader, Pauline Machu of France, just poised to take the lead. It's a few hundred metres now down into the stadium. Nowotna and Bartova also within touching distance. And here comes Russo, 21.7 seconds behind the leader. So Stablina growing her lead from the Canadian. Nowotna's going well. Nowotna of the Czech Republic. Bartova's missed one. Oh, she missed the last two, Nowotna, so she's off to do her penalties. But this is our new leader from France, Pauline Machu. So, a really good performance there on the range for Machu. Stablina right behind her. Rodner coming out of the stadium now as well. Russo sitting in sixth now. Four misses on the range for the Canadian. That's really proved the difference between herself and the leading bunch. So, how much of an advantage has Mashu got? We're at the 8.9 kilometre stage of 12.5k. So, this is beyond the penalty loop difference. 33.4 seconds between the leader and the chasing Ukrainians. And that does give Mashu some breathing space. Takes a little bit of pressure, not much, but a little bit of pressure off her in the range. Linka Botova's doing well for the Czech Republic. That's her second miss of the race. Another miss, so two misses. 300 meters of penalty loop to do. So you're looking at about 45 seconds added on to Mashu's time. And the split coming into the range was 37.4. So pressure on these two Ukrainians. Stabilna already misses one. Oh, miss for Horodna as well. Oh, two misses for Horodna, one for Stabilna. And Mashu gets a chance to breathe again. Mashu still doing her penalty loops, but very soon we'll see her leaving that penalty loop area and heading back off onto the track, and then we'll get a good idea and confirmation of who is actually out in front. And there is Mashu on the left, just ahead of Otkovska of the Czech Republic. So Mashu lives again, but she's lost that huge advantage of the previous lap. Now, does the Frenchwoman have it in her to catch the Czech and to stay ahead of the chasing Ukrainians, who are now just 14 seconds further back? Otkovska coming up to that 11.4 kilometer split. Now we get a good idea of just how much work the Frenchwoman has to do to close the gap and stand any chance of winning gold. And it's looking like it might prove too much. 21.3 seconds for Mashu. But she's running out of time and she's running out of track, as Stablina puts in a late charge as well. 32 seconds behind the leader, 11 seconds behind the current silver medalist. Here comes Shiloh Russo. Kristina Otkovska enters the stadium. She's just got a few hundred meters to go to the finish line. Look at this. Here she comes from the Czech Republic, the 22-year-old who's come out of nowhere in this race. Kristina Otkovska comes up to the finish line to claim the gold for the Czech Republic, their third medal in biathlon in these games. And then comes the French woman, Mashu, who has raced a fantastic race, let down in the end by her last shooting round. But she takes silver her second silver of the games for Pauline Machu. But look at that, another French woman right behind her, and I'm not sure Machu realized it is bronze. Bronze for Anna Blanc. Confirmation of the result of the women's 12.5 kilometer mass start then. A fantastic victory for Otkovska of the Czech Republic. And look at that, it's France in silver and in bronze as well. And there is the results for the rest of the field as well.
Anna Blanc! Second place, representing France, Pauline Machu! First place and biathlon women's 12.5 kilometer mass start champion, representing the Czech Republic, Kristina Otsovska! The Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games winners!
Confirmation of the medals. It's gold for the Czech Republic, and what a day for France. Pauline Machu and Anna Blanc taking silver and bronze. Three medals in total, including the men's, in one day for France. So that's how the biathlon panned out. That is it for biathlon here at the Lake Placid 2023 Games. Hope you've enjoyed it. From all of us, it's goodbye.